I'm Daniela. In this video, I'm going to talk about high voltage DC transmission. In 1879, Thomas Alva Edison invented the world's first practical incandescent light bulb. In those days, electricity was not yet distributed to any household. In order to sell his light bulbs, Edison realized that he first needed to generate and distribute electricity to every home. So he relied on direct current, or DC, which worked well with incandescent lamps. He generated 110 volt DC electricity. While transmitting this electricity, he faced a major challenge. In the destination, consumers received a very low power. Most of the electricity generated is lost during the transmission. As distance increased, power loss also increased. So, Edison could only supply consumers less than a mile from the generating station. Or in other words, his system required a power plant every mile or so. That model was extremely expensive. On the other hand, AC or alternating current gained attention as it could work for long distance at a significantly low cost. Nikola Tesla and George Westinghouse worked together and demonstrated AC distribution. Edison was not happy with the popularity of AC distribution. Edison and Westinghouse competed to get cities across the United States to use their system. As AC systems spread, Edison used the press to wage war against Westinghouse and Tesla. Edison advertised that AC is very dangerous, and to prove his statement, he even electrocuted many stray dogs, elephant, and even horses. Yes, Edison is an inventor, but not a great human being. In the end, Edison lost the current war and the AC won the battle. Now the question is, why couldn't Edison transmit his DC electricity long distance? It's actually due to a component called transformers. Let me clearly explain the logic behind this. No matter what we do, we are going to lose some power during transmission. But if we transmit electricity at very high voltages, we could minimalize these losses. As I said earlier, Edison generated 110 volt DC and transmitted this very low voltage electricity. That's why power loss was very high in that case. In order to increase voltage, we need a transformer. Step-up transformers convert low voltage high current input into high voltage low current output. However, transformers only work on AC system. They cannot be used in a DC system. In an AC power system, the generated electricity is first transmitted to a step-up transformer, which converts the low voltage into high voltage. Now, this high voltage is transmitted. Before delivering it to the consumers, step-down transformers convert this high voltage into low voltage. The principal advantage of AC is that it allows the use of transformers to change voltage levels. No equivalent of transformer exists for DC transmission, so the market for AC transmission increased. But the research on DC transmission was still going on. Swiss engineer René Thury was interested in this DC transmission, so he visited the laboratory of Thomas Edison. He realized that Edison's dynamo, or in other words, Edison's DC generator, could be significantly improved. Thury started working on this and finally solved the commutation problem of the dynamo. Later, to increase the high voltage DC output, Thury used multiple motor generator sets connected in series. Eventually, he developed commercial systems delivering 20 megawatts at 125 kilovolt over 230 kilometer. He was known as the king of DC. The main limitation of the Thury system was that it required very high maintenance due to high energy and rotary loss due to motor generator sets. This again proved that AC generators are more efficient than these. Therefore, attention was turned towards the mercury arc rectifiers. which converts AC into DC. So we are generating AC electricity. The generated electricity is first transmitted to a step-up transformer, which converts the low voltage into high voltage. This high voltage AC or HVAC is converted into high voltage DC or HVDC using mercury arc rectifier and then transmitted. Later, these mercury arc rectifiers are replaced by semiconductor rectifiers. Before delivering it to the consumers, it is converted back to AC. The step-down transformers convert this high voltage AC into low voltage. So, my question is, why do we have to do all these conversions? First, we are converting AC to DC and again back to AC. That is because high voltage DC transmission or HVDC have some advantages over HVAC or high voltage AC transmission. That will be discussed in my next video. Bye. See you all there.